Welcome to the I Love Winnipeg Real Estate Podcast, your premier resource for buying, owning, and investing in Winnipeg's real estate market. And now, here's your host, Adrian Schultz, who loves all things real estate, property management, and mortgage financing.
On this episode of the I Love Winnipeg Real Estate Podcast, we're going to speak about things that you can't forget to incorporate into your condo board's annual budget. Now, you might think that you can plan your budget for the upcoming year based on the previous year expenses. Just copy and paste and you're done, right? Not quite. While the previous year can provide a solid and general guide for planning purposes, you'll need to consider possible changes in year-over-year expenses. Specifically, here are five things that you don't want to forget about when drafting your condo board's budget for the upcoming year. First, costs resulting from weather conditions. One of the most common items that boards fail to remember is the weather. The fact is that no matter what the farmer's almanac says, you can't really plan for the weather next year. It's possible that there'll be several blizzards, necessitating additional snow removal, for example. Or a storm can come through and knock down trees, meaning you'll have to spend more on landscaping and cleanup. Ensuring your budget has sufficient wiggle room is essential when it comes to paying for these items. Secondly, taxes. Every year, taxes fluctuate on changes at the local, provincial, and federal levels. It's difficult to keep track of these on your own. Talk with an expert about how changes in tax law could have an impact during the next fiscal year. By doing so, you can accurately budget how much you'll need to set aside. Now, with taxes in this case, I'm speaking about things such as provincial and federal sales tax, but also in some cases, property tax in case the condominium property has some corporately owned units. Third, insurance deductibles. Just like the above items, emergencies and disasters don't follow any particular schedule. Fires and other catastrophes just happen. Be sure that you know exactly how much your insurance company will cover versus how much you'll be on the hook for. Budgeting for a single event that affects the whole community, such as a flood, is a wise idea. Fourth, legal fees. Most years, you probably won't have much in the way of legal fees. However, you never know when someone might file a suit against the condo corporation. Setting aside funds for legal expenses will help you avoid having to compromise other expense accounts in the event of a lawsuit. Fifth, reserve funds. Many condo boards consider reserve funds to be extra. They're often the first to be on the chopping block. However, these funds are crucial for covering unanticipated expenses. Not having enough in the reserve fund is a leading reason for why condo associations go into debt. Stay out of the red by setting aside plenty of reserve funds at the start of the budget process. If you don't end up using the money, you can always transfer it to the following year's budget. I would personally recommend that you abide by the capital contribution or reserve fund contributions as specified in your reserve fund study, which in most cases is updated every 5 years. If you have any questions about how to best plan for your condominium corporation's budget for the coming year, then the team at Imperial Properties can help. Imperial Properties has developed a strong reputation for sound and effective condominium management in Winnipeg, Manitoba. Our team is a leader in the field because we offer unparalleled management expertise paired with exceptional service, knowledge, efficiency, and cost-effectiveness to serve our diverse client base. Contact Imperial Properties today to learn how they can help you.
Thanks for listening to the I Love Winnipeg Real Estate Podcast. If you like this episode, please subscribe and give us a rating, which will help us reach more listeners. Until next time, connect with us on social media and online at ilovewinnipegrealestate.ca.